You open Affinity and realize something terrifying. It's time to actually make a document. Blank page, infinity possibilities, mild panic. Don't worry. Today we'll walk through creating your first proper project from scratch. No templates, no guessing, and no tears over margin. By the end of this video, you'll know how to pick the right size and orientation, set margin, bleed, and facing pages, understand the difference between print and press ready, and start your layout like a professional. Or at least someone who looks like one on YouTube. Let's start fresh.
Okay, now go to File, here, up here, File, New. And behold, the most confusing dialog box in the known universe. Don't panic, I'll walk you through it. On the left side, you have your preset that Affinity have made for you. Here is page sizes for RGB, for SMIC, for photo, for your canvas, video and web, and different devices. And let's go up again. And if you click on any of those pages, you see changes happening on the right side panel. On the right side, this is where you see your page sizes and units. Let's keep it A4 right now. See document units here. Choose what your brain understands. Millimeters if you are civilized, inches if you are American, and pixels only if you plan to cry later. DPI. Let's keep it 300, that's good for print. Under multi-page, if you scroll down a little, click on multi-page. And here you see default masters, check it. This will create a background page that controls repeating stuff like headers, footer, and page numbers. We'll use that later. Now, up here, you see your facing pages, and a little bit down is start on, and it's marked right. Here's the deal. Facing pages means left and right pages side by side, like a book or a magazine. Start on right means your first page is on the right side, because that's how books open. For brochures and single flyer, leave it unthick. For this tutorial, pick facing pages if it's not already thick. And let's put start on right. Set number of pages 1. You can add more later. Layout doesn't automatically link text frames between new pages, so it's better to start small and build. Now, let's scroll up a little bit, and here you see your color settings. This section is for picking your color format and profile. Stick with the CMYK 8 under color profile. Right now, you can leave it US web coded V2, but you should ask from print house what they prefer. For instance, I know where I live, like 95% of print houses want to get coded Bogra 39. So I will check this one. In your case, like I said, you can leave it US web coded SWOP V2. But if you are doing a real thing and you can send it on the print house, you should ask print house what color profile they want. If you're making a digital only PDF, then you can switch it to RGB 8, like color format. Here's drop down, and you can choose here RGB 8. But in our cases, in tutorial purposes, keep it CMYK. We want those colors to look as expensive as your printer ink. Now, let's scroll down. The margins. Margins are visible safety zones. Anything important that crosses them might get chopped off when printed. For A4, actually 10 millimeters are enough. And you can click on this link icon, link margins. Click on that. Let's put it then here. Click off, and automatically it changes everything to 10. Equal margin on every side. Next, let's look a little bit down. Here is bleed. This is the opposite of margin. It's how far artwork extends beyond the page, so it can be safely trimmed. Set it to 3 or In my case, I like to put it 5 just in case, and the bleed should be same size on all sides. It's small, but it prevents those sad white lines that ruin your print job. If you're gonna use those settings again and again, it's easier to save it. So all you have to do is scroll up where is A4 and create preset here. You can give it a descriptive name. Let's put it A4 fog ra 39, so I know the color profile, and 300, meaning TPI, and let's put 5 millimeters bleed. And now just create preset, and it appears on the left side with the name you gave it. Now take a deep breath. You are officially 1% less terrified program. Now that we have set up everything in new page window, just create document, and you have your new document here. Now, before typing anything, let's set up a master page. Go to document, view master. It's up here, document, pages, view master, and open. It's this page here, this one. If you don't want to use document panel view masters, all you have to do is just double click it, and you are in the same place. That's the background that controls every page based on it. Grab a frame text tool. It's this the key in the box. Shortcut is key. And drag a box inside your margin guide. If you're gonna use both sides, then just click on this little arrow here, this little blue arrow. Click it and make another text frame. Now you see this blue line here, that one. This means those two text frames are linked. If you want to see it, go to text, insert, filler text. And now you can see those two are connected. You can take the move tool and see, they are connected. Now the text will flow naturally on pages, and lorem ipsum, your fake friend for life. Let's make it look more official. Draw a small text frame at the bottom of the page. That's your footer. So let's give it a little bit more room. Again, let's take the text tool and let's make a little square here. Inside it, be sure it's your cursor is here, blinking, yes. Text, insert, fields, page numbers. Layout shows it as a hashtag on the master page. On a real page, it becomes actual number. You can also add a document title or chapter name next to it if you want. In the tutorial purposes, let's make it. So option drag, option shift drag, and what did now? We made a few sides. Let's take both of those, click option or alt, hold shift, and drag it on the other page. Let's do little changes here next to it, that one next to it, and let's align them. If you're searching a line, it's up here in this context bar here. Write the line. Now, if you go to your pages, this is your work, so just double click it and you see Affinity tutorial. Let's toggle preview mode. Looks nice. And now, if you are making more pages, here is this add page icon. Click on it, add page window will pop up. And here is master that we are using, master A. Here and here, those are saved. How many number of pages I want? 2 is enough for now. Then insert it after, see, after, insert after page 1. And okay. And you see, it's all numbered, and you didn't have to do it manually.
All right, you've gone from blank panic to fully functional document. Proper size and bleed, facing pages, margins that protect your layout, link text frames, and automatic page numbers. You officially build a foundation worth saving. In next video, we'll dive deeper how to actually work with text inside those frames. Fonts, spacing, flowing, and that one setting that ruins everything when you ignore it. Hit subscribe so you don't miss it. And don't forget, save your masterpiece before layout crashes out of spite. See you in video 5.